Hi, I'm Soccer Sam, and you're watching the Billy Andracki Show.
Nah, dog. I'm Soccer Sam, and you're watching the Scott Schweitzer Show.
Soccer fans, put on your cleats. Tape on your shin guards. If you're sleeping, wake up! Yeah, you! It's time for America's wackiest, craziest, zaniest, and every otherest adjective I can think of. It's time for the hottest soccer show in the galaxy, the Soccer Sam Show, coming at you. Feel the kick!
Hi, welcome to the Soccer Sam Show. I'm Billy Andracki, and today we're going to timeline back to 1996 when we opened up against the Montreal Impact. So, Sky, where were you back then?
I was back with the Carolina Dynamo dominating the USISL League.
Let's go, Rhinos! Let's go!
Steve Adamek are the linesmen, and Steve Baum will be the fourth official. Game is underway here at Rochester's Frontier Field. Again, this is a shorter field than Montreal, and Valerio Gazzola says they will waste no time with the ball in their zone. Back and forth. Nice little touch by DeSantis. He's able to get it to Fletcher. Barker. Now Dolescat. Across. Off the head. And out of play. And as you mentioned in the opening, Patrick is just dominant.
Oh, he is absolutely dominant. You know, he's having a very strong season. Oh, ball played forward right now. You know, right in the early going, Montreal is absolutely not hesitating to just send that ball forward any means possible. They just want to get the ball upfield, and I think they feel that on a small field like this, that's the strategy to use. They won't have room to construct, so they're just trying to play the ball forward and get possession of it there with the big guys.
Marinaro with the ball. Marinaro! Top down by Nick DeSantis. Going to be a penalty kick. Now DeSantis is chasing the referee and not very happy, and he's pushed the referee. DeSantis being held back by Paolo Ceccarelli. Now Limniadis is in the middle of it. DeSantis wants at the referee.
Good call by the ref.
Ceccarelli has only given up one goal in penalty kicks in a shootout, and he makes the save! An outstanding save by Paolo Ceccarelli against Hector Marinaro.
Who was coming to contest the call. Now here's the save. Look at this fantastic save by Paolo Ceccarelli. Now, often on a save for a penalty shot, you get the feeling that Montreal's aerial game is going to get Rochester earlier on in this game than we can expect. It's going to be very easy balls, just like this, cross down the middle, but I think that's going to be dangerous.
On the cross, it goes in goal! Bing, bing, bing! You called it, Patrick. And on the cross, it went down, off one foot, then to another. And 15 minutes in, the Montreal Impact take a 1-0 lead.
And very lucky to get that rebound. See it here. Ball deflects off Leon Minot, his marking, and goes into the net. Nothing Phil Andracki could do about that ball. Good taking a fight.
Limniadis and Lowe. Lowe takes it. Look at him swing in goal! What a shot! Does it again, it's 2-0.
Cross that thing, forget it. Ananda Lowe tees it up.
He hooked that in perfectly. Andracki again, really had no chance at. Rivas trying to work it in, it goes off Diot. Jason Davos now working there against Hector Marinaro. Rhinos control. Smotrich on the far side against Lowe. Drops it off and leaves it. Now Kelly's got it. Tanner to the near side. Rivas.
Rivas, here's a clear pass. Great save by Ceccarelli. And it's loose. Ball still loose. They're trying to kick it in goal.
I believe it was Doug Miller in the middle of all that who put it in, but there were a lot of bodies around. Here we get the replay. Pinball, anyone? Great volley shot by Hector Marinaro. Place it back in. The ball's finally kicked in, and I don't think Miller got a foot on it. I think it went off Paolo Ceccarelli. Ceccarelli into the net. A lot of traffic, a lot of bouncing around.
Control is the key word for the Impact in the second half. They've scored the goals they need to win this game. The onus of making the play is now on Rochester. It's not the other way around. Montreal's got the result they want if it stands. And as a result, they can go back, consolidate their defense, consolidate their midfield, let Rochester come to them and try to open up the spaces that'll come with that. And let me tell you, if two players can fill that space, Onando Lowe and Lloyd Barker are the two to do it.
Lowe had five shots in the first half. Two goals. DeSantis with one shot, Barker with the other. There were four shots by Miller, and watch the play now coming in. Miller had four, Marinaro three, and a shot each by Tanner Kelly and Mackay.
Now this is a very dangerous situation. Marinaro is very good from this distance. He's placing people around, but this is a very, very dangerous position. Actually, Marinaro's not even lining up for it.
Right hand, oh. Right foot, that was Steenkamp. As the play taken out by the Montreal Impact. Impact wearing the white jerseys and the blue short. Rhinos in the black. I guess that's raging black.
Rochester's pressing forward slowly but surely.
Off the corner. Marinaro. Marinaro right foot. Can he find a head? It goes off the head. Still up. Ball is loose.
The ball was cleanly played by every player. The only possible contestation was offside, and I'm going to have a look at that replay to see whether or not there is any possibility of offside. But you felt the danger there. You know, Rochester was pushing forward. Marinaro plays that little ball in, and then it's beautifully chipped across. And the ball is played back. Looks like Rene gets his head on that. Header there. Ceccarelli's in big traffic. It is.
He had to worry about two guys. Tanner was there, Miller was there, and it was Miller who was able to finally get a foot on it.
Ceccarelli made the right decision. He had to try to get something onto that ball. Rivas does a great job, but he's out of play, and he doesn't get back in. Now, if you're off the field of play, you can't be offside. You have to be the last player down on the field of play. Fanta, even the goalies went up and shot during the shootout. Just to give you an idea of how tough it was, and finally after 12 rounds, Hector Marinaro scored his second goal of the shootout after his second round through. But they lost four straight before that, and they don't want to take this to a shootout. They
Kofi with a two goal.
A chance after Rochester. Kelly open, and Ceccarelli comes back to get a hand on it, push it away. Well, Kofi was showing what he could do right away.
It really has been a different game since then. We haven't seen Onando Lowe get much. In all fairness to him, Montreal's been back on its heels. They've been spending a lot of time defending. He hasn't had that many quality balls to deal with.
Lemniadis, Davos. Diot is the man back.
Now the little white spot right behind the ball is in fact the 35-yard shootout line, so this shot being taken from a good 30 yards out.
Davos in low, and it gets through. Billy Andracki makes the save. That got through. I'm not sure if he saw that until the last moment.
Powerful shot by Jason Davis. Takes a hop, another hop. Bill Andracki gets to it. Very nice job to cover up. But the big shot is not Lyndon Hooper's thing.
see Kelly looking for Miller. Miller's already got two. That's Miller on the far side. Cassini. Smotrich. Cassini. They've looked at the clock. They know how much time's left. Tanner to Rene. The pass wasn't that sharp, but look who comes back with it. Tanner. Tanner moves in, edge of the box, swings it wide. Miller in a race with Diot. Diot just clears it out.
Diot, not the speediest guy in the world, but he always gets great position on his attacker, and you can see it right there. You were going to have to go through him to get the ball.
Kelly to Rene. Rene fakes, moves into the box. Here's a chance of Rochester. Goal! A beauty! The shirt is off. Miller has completed the trick.
Lino Saputo was standing right nearby when that goal went in, and even he applauded and said that is a very, very nice goal, a wonderful construction. Hey, the names we've been saying all second half. Rene gets the ball, and look out with this fake. Goodbye. Sends the ball into Marinaro. Remember what I was saying about Marinaro's first touch? It's magic. Beautiful play in. Nick Cassantis had the opportunity to handball that thing to stop it. He wasn't going to allow a second penalty. Look at this beautiful, beautiful play. Kofi Debra in a slight offside position, but he never even came close to playing the ball. Referee didn't whistle that one. Just a perfect, perfect goal. And it really caps the Rochester domination in this second half.
If they can get the change in, Nash getting the crowd involved.
He wants them to applaud Tommy Tanner.
There's
for his great game, and he did play a very, very good game. A lot of running, a lot of it off the ball, but if Rochester's been getting space, it's because everybody on this very small field, if they're getting space, it's not because of the size of the field, it's because they're doing a lot of running.
There's time, and what a way to welcome Frontier Field with a victory. And the happiest guy could be the head coach, Pat Ercole, who is hugging everybody he can find in a Rhino sweater. The Rhinos came out, got a little dazzled, I think, Patrick, by the Montreal Impact, but showed the control and patience, and when the advantage was there, Doug Miller made them count.
I mean, you know, you have to say one thing for the Impact. They played a solid first half, but really, their chances came from Onanda Low, and he buried every chance he got. On the other side, Rochester played, a barely tolerable first 45 minutes. Their marking was off, their running was bad, their opportunities were missed. But in the second half, boy, did they pour it on.
What room gets more use than your kitchen?
This one salesperson, I swear, could read my mind. Didn't try to oversell me.
We have ceramic tiles, we have vinyl tiles, we have countertops.
I know this contractor. He's sold on Chase Pitkin's quality.
Real wood cabinets, not that particle board stuff. All kinds of finishes.
Kitchens and baths are a big investment.
You gotta do it right.
We'll help from design to finish. Chase Pitkin. You don't have to do it yourself.
Lots of people have a look. Only a few have the goods to back it up. Like Dodge Neon SXT, with 132-horse engine, jamming CD sound, aluminum wheels, and much more. It's got the whole package for just $12,450. Or choose 0% financing. Either way, you get our 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it. Dodge Neon SXT, how style and performance hook up for around $12,400.
Soccer Sam Show's on every Saturday at noon and midnight right here on Rochester's WB 16.
Today's Family Italian Restaurant. Every Monday, kids eat free. That's right, kids eat free on Mondays. Tuesdays, kids half price. Bring the whole family into Soccer Sam's at 2045 Empire Boulevard.
It's okay to tell a bad referee to kick this.
Yeah, it's to listen, to kick this radio
show. Listen to the Kick This radio show.
Charisma means the joy of two young hearts. Charisma means fond memories. Charisma means love.
Charisma, when you care.
2275 Ridge Road West.
Welcome back to the Soccer Sam Show on WB.
Now we're going to go to some MLS highlights. Hey, Billy, what's your favorite MLS team?
I would have to say my favorite MLS team right now is probably San Jose. They got this goalkeeper who's just on fire, except for one little play, but you know, we all forget about those goalkeeper mistakes at times.
You know, I think my favorite team is the Colorado Rapids. And I love the goalie there. He's great. He's playing awesome.
Scott Garlick?
No. I played with him in Carolina when we were dominating the USISL. But I like Scott Fallow.
Oh, Scott Fallow. Now let's go to some WUSA highlights. Scotty, you got any favorite WUSA players?
No doubt, Charmaine Cooper from NC State. I know she's Canadian, but you gotta represent. She's an NC State Wolfpacker.
Sunshines. Bobby Greenfield here. The soccer... Hello, lovely. Soccer Sam will be right back. There's a ball. There's some balls. Oh, my gosh. Look at all those balls.
Have you given my dad a chance to say yes to you?
Mr. and Mrs. Glunky from Fairport, did my dad say yes to you?
Mal yay. We always say yes.
John and Steve Nardozzi from Victor, did my dad say yes to you?
Mal yay. We always say yes.
He sure did.
I promise, if you give me a chance to say yes to you, you too will be singing.
Mal yay. We always say yes.
Today's Family Italian Restaurant. Every Monday, kids eat free. That's right, kids eat free on Mondays. Tuesdays, kids half price. Bring the whole family into Soccer Sam's at 2045 Empire Boulevard.
Hi, welcome to Soccer Sam's. How many kids?
I got a ham sandwich and some pretzels. You want some pretzels?
No, I'm about to trade you some cookies or something.
Like what?
I don't know.
Button orange.
Get it. Hey, Jay, you got anything?
Don't ask Jay.
Why not?
Jay never has anything.
What's up with that?
Are you on a diet or something?
Yeah, a diet. Mm-hmm. Jay's on a diet. That's all right, man. We understand. My mom's on a diet.